We're in the studio today, and I'm sitting down with Heather and Allison from Compass Regional Hospice to talk about a very special event and all the wonderful things that they're doing. So, welcome, ladies.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Thanks for having us.
Of course. So you guys are doing so much.
We are. We really have grown as a hospice organization over the years. We employ over 100 employees now in the counties. We serve Queen Anne's, Kent, and Caroline counties. We not only have hospice services in those counties, but we also have grief services in all the counties and also in all the school systems. We're offering lots of different programmings through our grief services for, unfortunately, opioid overdose people who've lost people to opioid overdose, suicide, car accidents, any kind of traumatic event. Our counselors are certified in that. So we offer that free of charge. Again, like I said, we're in all the school systems and all the counties counseling children so they don't have to leave their natural environment of the school to go to a counseling room or something that might make them feel, you know, uneasy or different than the other kids in the school. And through our hospice services, we see patients in their home environment, as well as we have two facilities. We have our facility here in Centerville. And we also have a facility in Kent County, in the hospital, actually, in Chestertown. So, and we're in the process of expansion. We've been undergoing a capital campaign for the last couple years, and we're only about $580,000 shy of our goal of $4 million. And we are going to start, we're in the process of selecting our builder now, and I'm going to hopefully start we've already done renovations in the one side of the building, but to do the larger renovations and expansion in April.
That's great. That's a great update. Yeah. I remember just hearing when you just started talking about wanting to expand.
Right, right. That's the community has really come behind us and supported us as they always have in the past. And so we will go from 6 beds in Centerville to 10. And it's really needed because most oftentimes people have to wait to get a bed in either one of our facilities. And we also see patients in nursing homes and assisted livings and group homes. So wherever the patient calls their home.
Right. You guys are expanding, you're doing a lot. Mm-hmm. And I guess that even means doing events, right? So you have this nice program that's happening.
We do.
Yeah.
So our hospice and other hospices around the country are part of an initiative with the We Honor Veterans program, which is a collaboration between the National Hospice and Palliative Care Organization and the Veterans Administration. And the We Honor Veterans program is a 5-tiered program, which we are a proud level 4 member of, and soon to be level 5. And in order to meet those goals and to get that accreditation, you have to provide things like veteran volunteer to veteran patient services. So we really work hard to recruit veteran volunteers and then match them with patients that have similar life histories, and think that's really important in end of life for someone to feel comfortable with who their volunteer is and who they're spending time with. We also provide veteran remembrance ceremonies. We provide recognition ceremonies for patients by providing a lap blanket that's like a patriotic quilt. And then we have a tabletop flag and then a certificate that's signed by our board chair and by our executive director, Heather. So we have had veterans also that were from, we had an astronaut one time that we got really cool paperwork from NASA and like a piece of a flag that was flown, and we had time to work with them, and it's a really nice opportunity for families to recognize their veteran family member. And quite often it's the last celebration that families have with their loved ones. So it's a really special time. And an honor to be part of that time in our veterans' end-of-life care. We also have certain veteran benefits that we try to ensure our veterans are aware of, like concurrent care. So our veterans that are still going for chemotherapy or dialysis or aggressive treatments, they can also access hospice care at the same time, which is really unique compared to a standard hospice patient. So they don't have to necessarily make that choice. They can kind of have the best of both worlds and get that hospice support earlier and while they're still navigating their treatment options. So we try to make sure that all of our veterans programs are run the way that, that the We Honor Veterans program would want it as a level four partner, and soon to be will attain that level five. And part of that is veteran-centric events. And we are really excited because we were able to collaborate with Coastal Hospice, which is down on the Lower Shore, and Talbot Hospice in Talbot County, and of course our Compass Hospice. And the three of us are going to be hosting the Welcome Home Vietnam Veterans Day event on Saturday, March 30th from 1 to 3 at Easton High School.
This is a Big Shore event.
Yes,
and it's a Big Shore event. This is, so now no more crossing the bridge.
Right.
Everyone can be close to home.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. This is a, March 30th is a national recognition day for Welcome Home Vietnam Veterans Day, and it's something that's done across the country, but this will be the first time that we're able to have this event on the shore, so we're really glad to bring it here. Travel is an issue for a lot of our Vietnam veterans. Mm-hmm. A lot of them, you know, are older and maybe don't want to travel across the bridge, or, you know, just to have this regional event that their families can come to. All veterans are welcome to attend. We will be specifically honoring Vietnam veterans, but we invite anyone that would like to attend to please join us. There is a registration on our website and our Facebook page, and the flyer I know shows the registration as well. If you can register ahead, that would be great. If you are a military and want to wear your uniform, that's encouraged as well. And we have lots of activities planned for that day.
Yeah, and there will be a pinning ceremony?
There will. We have a Vietnam veterans pinning ceremony, so it's a great opportunity for any Vietnam veteran that hasn't had the chance to be pinned. Yeah, that's a special ceremony. There also will be guest speakers. Mm-hmm. General Adkins is our keynote speaker. We have two other speakers lined up as well. We have musicians that will be performing, a bagpiper. There's a round table ceremony.
That
with
amazing.
Yeah, it's we tried to make it a really dynamic day. Hogs and Heroes is going to be there.
Yeah.
So there are a lot resources. Of different agencies and resources. Yeah, we have lots of veteran resource tables that we're hoping, and of course refreshments and time for fellowship.
Well, definitely. Yeah, definitely refreshments.
You can't go anywhere without that.
That's right. So yeah, please dress up, right? That would be amazing. That'd be nice to see everyone dress up in uniform.
If it
get
fits,
pinned.
Wear it. That's the
or you have a couple days to get in shape. Put the whole uniform on.
Right.
That's amazing. Well, that'll be a fun event. And again, it's at the Easton High School.
Yes, at Easton High
March
School.
30th.
Yeah, March 30th from 1 to 3.
So that's just one event that's coming
up. That's one event that's coming up. Yeah.
But you guys are doing so much more also.
Yes.
And you have a new program developing also?
We do. We do. We're really excited about it. As of February 1st, we started a community-based palliative care program. And what that is palliative care is really this new buzzword in the medical field. We as an acute care provider or post-acute care provider really partners with our hospital systems to help to keep patients from continuing to go back to the hospital for the same treatment over and over again or the same symptoms. So we have created this palliative care program, and ours is specifically for patients who do have a life-limiting illness or a serious illness. And we go into the home setting with our social workers, our nurse practitioner, and our physician, Dr. Tom Walsh. He is really spearheading and running the program and will be seeing all the palliative care patients. So patients come onto our palliative care program when they're not quite ready to accept the hospice philosophy, and or they are still seeking aggressive treatment. And so it is a way for our staff to build a relationship with the patient and family as they continue down their trajectory of their disease and their treatments. And then when they are when they are finished with their treatments or they're ready to accept the hospice philosophy, then they are transferred into our hospice program.
Gotcha. So this is a great first or transitional step.
Right.
Gotcha.
Yes.
So you guys are doing so much, but how can people help you in return?
Great question. So Compass Regional Hospice is a nonprofit organization, obviously. So we count on our community support, like we talked about with the capital campaign, but not only for building, but just for our general operating budget every year. We have to fundraise about a third of our annual budget in order to be able to provide the services that we do to the community. So we really do look for the support of our community through mailings, mailing appeal letters, our special events that we have annually, and making memorial donations in lieu of flowers when somebody passes away. And also, Allison can talk a little bit about our volunteer program.
Sure.
Yeah, volunteering is another great way to give back. We do have about 300 volunteers, which seems like so many, but we use them for so many different things, so we're always looking for new volunteers. And a lot of times people think, I don't really want to, you know, be with a hospice patient or do companion volunteering, and that's one component of volunteering which we're really grateful to have, but that's not for everybody. So we do have clerical volunteers in our administrative office. I have volunteers that do outreach with me and work health fairs and different things like that, or speaking engagements. We have volunteers that do some handiwork on some handyman type things that we need done. So we use volunteers for Camp New Dawn, which is a huge component of our volunteer corps. So we use volunteers for all different kinds of things. So if you're interested in volunteering, again, our website, compassregionalhospice.org, is a great way to look at all the volunteer trainings that are going to be coming up and figure out how you can get involved.
Yeah, and lastly, we have our estate treasurer's resale shop, which is in Chester, in the Kent Town Market, and we have hundreds of volunteers that run that store on a daily basis. So if you're interested in getting out and being social with some ladies and gentlemen and volunteering in that capacity in a retail shop, it's a lot of fun.
So there's always more information though.
Yes.
So where should they go if they want more information about Compass?
So for more information, please visit our website, compassregionalhospice.org. Or give us a call, 443-262-4100.
And I think it's real important now, as Allison has given our contact information, just to say that anybody in the community, if you feel your neighbor needs help, mm-hmm. your loved one, a friend, anybody can call our hospice and make a referral or inquire about our programs, because we have so many different programs now between our grief services, our hospice, and our palliative care that we often can help almost anybody who's in need.
Right, great. So in the meantime, while you're waiting for the amazing event for veterans, check out their website if you think it's something that might help you or help the loved one, and they'll always be ready for you. So thank you, ladies, for stopping by.
Thank you.
See you next time.